Hello everyone, this is Neal Davis from Digital Cloud Training. If you're planning to get a job in the world of cloud computing working with AWS, then when you go for an interview, you need to be ready with some ideas of what sorts of questions might come up in the interview. So what I'm going to do in this particular video is I'm going to cover some of the types of questions that are likely to come up if you're going for a junior level job, perhaps something like a junior cloud engineer or a junior technical account manager. Now, if you're going for one of those types of jobs, then you may want to get the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner certification. And that will really set you up with the foundational skills that you need on AWS. Now, if you're going for a job at that level, what sort of thing might the interviewers ask you? So what we did is we wrote an article, it's on our website, and there's 20 questions which are very common and really are designed around that curriculum from the Certified Cloud Practitioner certification. Those are the types of things that are going to come up if you're going for one of those junior job roles. Now, the link for that article is in the description of this video, so please feel free to check that out. And what I'll do now is I'm going to cover a few of the main ones and explore them in a little bit more detail. So one of the first questions they might ask you is, what are the core benefits of AWS? Now, I advise you to go and check out the 6 advantages of cloud computing. If you search in Google with that search term, you will find a document from AWS themselves. And what they do is they outline what they see as the 6 advantages of moving to cloud computing. Now, the first one is that you trade fixed expense for variable expense. So accountants might say that you move from CapEx to OpEx. You have a variable cost each month rather than an upfront capital cost. The next one is you benefit from massive economies of scale. AWS is huge. They're all over the world and they have thousands of customers, some of the biggest companies in the world. So because they have such a huge amount of purchasing power, they get to lower their costs for acquisition of all the hardware and software that they use. Also, they have a lot of efficiencies through the systems that they design and build and then offer to many different customers. The next one is stop guessing capacity. That simply means that rather than guessing how much compute power you need and often overpaying and buying too much, you actually get to dynamically change the amount of compute power you use on AWS, and you only ever pay for what you actually use at the time. The third one is to increase speed and agility. That means bringing new services to market faster. If a company wants to innovate quickly, then using cloud services, they can do that because lots of the services like analytics services and databases and machine learning, artificial intelligence, and many more are already there in the cloud, ready to use. All you have to do is work out how you want to use them, load your data, and you can start innovating very quickly using the cloud. The fifth advantage is to stop spending money running and maintaining data centers. So if you come from the traditional world of IT, then you have a data center, and in that data center, you have a lot of hardware that you own, all the compute, storage, networking, and other systems that you need to run your applications. It's very expensive, lots of capital cost, and lots of operational management costs as well. So better to just move to the cloud and pay for what you need when you need it. The last of the 6 advantages is to go global in minutes. What that means is you can deploy your applications all over the world very, very quickly. Used to be a very long process if you wanted to actually deploy something into a different part of the world, but with the cloud, it's super easy. So those are the 6 advantages of cloud computing. Definitely something that could come up in a interview for a junior level position or any position, to be honest. Another question is, what is the AWS well-architected framework? Now, this is something that you are expected to know for the cloud practitioner exam, and also it may well come up in interviews because employers want to make sure that their employees understand how to follow frameworks such as the AWS well-architected framework, which guides you with best practices and strategies to ensure that you implement designs and essentially your applications on AWS in the best way. So what else might they ask? Well, they might get a bit more technical and start asking you about the AWS global infrastructure, how AWS is set up, and then maybe some of the core services. Firstly, they may ask about regions. So what is a region? A region in AWS terminology is a physical location somewhere in the world that has multiple availability zones. Now, the availability zones are essentially data centers, and you don't know exactly where they are, but you always get at least three availability zones in each geographical region, and they're fairly close together. We don't know exactly how close, but they're fairly close together. So you can deploy your applications across AZs in order to get redundancy. Then, if you need to deploy applications much further away or in different parts of the world, you deploy them into a separate AWS region. Scalability is a common question. So there could be all sorts of different questions they'll ask here. They might ask the difference between scalability and elasticity, or they might ask you to describe what AWS auto-scaling is. So let's just explore those. So with scalability, what that means is as your application experiences higher demand, you want AWS to dynamically allocate more resources to that application so that it can service the load without failing or without slowing down and having some performance impacts. So that would be scalability, scaling in response to demand. Now, elasticity refers to the fact that we can scale out, we can add more compute power, and we can scale back in again when we no longer need it. So that means it's elastic. And in other words, you're paying as you have more demand, and you're paying less when you have less demand. Now, AWS auto-scaling is one of the services that you can use to enable this, and it can work for a variety of different services on AWS. For example, very commonly, we've got Amazon EC2 auto-scaling. That will launch and terminate EC2 instances on demand based on CloudWatch metrics, so performance metrics that indicate the load that the servers are under. With AWS auto-scaling, you can also dynamically scale databases like Amazon DynamoDB as well. Now, I would recommend that you understand some of the core services on AWS. If you do your Cloud Practitioner certification, you're definitely going to understand the use cases for many of the core services. And that's the key thing. For the junior level positions, you might not get asked any particularly advanced questions, but you will be expected to understand what these services are. So let's go through a few. So you've got Amazon EC2, that's the Elastic Compute Cloud, basically virtual servers in the cloud, Linux, Windows, and in some cases, Mac operating systems running in virtual servers in the cloud. We got the Amazon S3 service, the simple storage service. That's an object-based storage system in the cloud. You got AWS Lambda, that's a compute service that runs functions. Essentially means that code is run on demand in response to some kind of trigger. We got Amazon RDS, that's the relational database service. That's a managed relational database in the cloud. So think about things like Microsoft SQL Server or MariaDB. Those are both examples of relational databases, and Amazon will manage them for you. Another really important service is the virtual private cloud, the VPC service. That's like a virtual data center in the cloud. You can launch all of your resources within a VPC. You get to define the subnet ranges that you want to use, and they're private to your particular account. So those are just a few. If you do the Cloud Practitioner certification, if you use our training, for example, you'll learn many, many more than that. But those are just a few examples of some services you might be expected to know. Another one would be about the AWS shared responsibility model. So the shared responsibility model is a model in which AWS helps us to understand who is responsible for what from a security perspective. So we have AWS, they're the provider, and then we have the customer. And the customer is responsible for many aspects, and of course, AWS is responsible for others. So you can think of it in simple terms, AWS is responsible for the data center, the availability of their services. You're responsible for things like ensuring your data is encrypted and that you've used the security features that AWS provide for you. And I'll just cover one more in this video, and that is the AWS pricing models. They may very well want to make sure that you understand how AWS charge for the services that you use in the cloud. So there's a few options. Of course, we all understand that AWS has a pay-as-you-go model. We often call that on-demand as well. So that means that you can quickly launch resources and you pay for how long you use them and the amount of the resource that you consumed. Now, sometimes you can save more when you reserve. So that means you reserve for either 1 year or 3 years, a certain amount of capacity, and then you can get a larger discount. Another one is pay less by using more. And that's where we have tiered pricing models. And the more you use, the lower the unit cost becomes when you hit certain thresholds of usage. And then lastly, of course, there is a free tier. So some services provide a certain amount of free usage, either on an ongoing basis or for the first year that you have your account. So those are just a few AWS interview questions. If you go to the article on our website, you can learn much more there. You can also learn more about our bootcamp program. So if you're serious about coming into the AWS cloud industry and developing a high-paying cloud career, we have a live training program where you get to be taught by some of the industry experts who've been working in this industry for many years, multiple decades for many of them, and career coaches who know how to set you up for success and make sure that you're doing all the right things so you get noticed in the crowd when there's many people trying to apply for a job. We want to make sure that you can get through to the front and get the best chance of placing into that job role. So go to our website, have a look. You can find out more information about our bootcamp program, as well as find some more AWS interview questions.